Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Singaporean Talks Money. Don't forget to give an early thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you like the content that I have been producing. So on to today's video topic, habits and routines of millionaires, how you can use them to improve your productivity. So millionaires seem to spend their time differently from others. When it comes to exercising, reading, working, and usage of their social media. How then can we curate our habits and actions to improve not just our financial status, but our life routine as a whole to benefit the different aspects of our life? So follow me through today's video as I outline the possible changes that you can implement in your lifestyle. So firstly, millionaires exercise. And this is a really important aspect of rich and successful people. They don't forget about their health and exercise pretty frequently to ensure that they have the energy and stamina to last them through a long work day. So they tend to spend more time exercising than the average person. And this is for them to build up their body as they prepare for a day of decision making. So research has shown that they do have more time to exercise because they use less time on social media. And a study by Social Science and Medicine involving a sample of 5,042 Finnish twin males aimed to investigate the direct effects of physical activities on long-term labor income and earnings. And the results showed that being physically active positively influence long-term income, with physically active males receiving incomes some 14 to 17% higher than less active males. So from that study, it was found that it could be because exercise may improve a person's performance at work by enhancing their perseverance when faced with obstacles, and it also helped foster goal-oriented behaviors, which also develop their social skills. So in addition, physical activity may also encourage participation in competitive situations within the workplace by enhancing self-esteem, self-confidence, and locus of control. So another thing that millionaires tend to have is that they have a very rich mindset. So having a good mindset is very important to get us to achieve our goals. A focused mindset is beneficial to a confident, and a rich mindset is what differentiates the capable individuals. So what exactly is a rich mindset? So individuals with a rich mindset seek to spend their time, resources, and energy on work that continues to pay off long after the effort has been invested. So to do so, you will first need to step out of your comfort zone to do things that will benefit you in the long run, even though you are not comfortable doing them. You will also need to know what motivates you to get things started and moving. When you set big goals for yourself, you kind of adjust your thinking and actions to move towards it. And in order to reach your goals, you cannot invalidate yourself. If you keep telling yourself that you aren't smart enough or good enough, or that you don't know enough, it's not going to be easy to turn on a steady stream of cash flow. And with a hard and fast, low earning mindset, constant negative self-talk, you won't be able to grow and develop a rich mindset. So you will need to focus on what you can control. Example is that maybe you can start a side business, work on negotiating your salary, automate your finances, all these which you can control it, instead of giving up at the first sight of failure and finding comfort in complaining. Successful people usually rises up to the occasion and do what they can. So another habit or routine that they do is that they build relationships. So there is a study that suggests that you are the average of 5 people you surround yourself with. So it is your choice to choose people with a rich mindset or people with a poor mindset. Choosing your friend is a very crucial task because a good network can help you grow and develop a rich mindset for which we are about. So you do not have to be afraid to make friends that talk about finances, money, because they might help you in learning new ways. And having a circle of good friends on which you can rely upon will also boost your self-confidence. Next is that they tend to read up a lot. So reading helps you to have new ideas and knowledge about the topics that you're interested in. So I watched a Netflix documentary on Bill Gates, where he had Think Weeks, which was a 1 week period, 2 times a year, where he would just spend the whole week reading. So this was like creating a third place that is not work or home and allowed him to have deeper and more creative thoughts. So reading up more expands your horizon as more knowledge on a certain topic can be found. It allows you to be exposed to more areas and to be able to deep dive into what you're interested in. So last but not least is that they wake up a little earlier than others. So this is personally a personal tip from me. Of course, not as a millionaire, but ever since working from home, my workload has increased substantially. And during my normal workday, many people would call or have meetings with me virtually. And this consumes up a lot of my working daytime. So I sometimes do not have the time to clear my individual work or emails. So by waking up an hour earlier, it allows and gives me some time in the morning to clear and focus on my urgent tasks for the day and to complete them if possible first thing in the morning. And in turn, this really helps me to set my day ahead to completing all my other tasks, and it helps in the long run. So finishing up this whole episode, I would like to have a special feature as well on Elon Musk. So what Elon Musk does is that he wakes up early and ensures that he sleeps about 6 hours per day. So having a sufficient amount of sleep is very, very important because it sets you up for the day. And by staying up the whole night, maybe catching up on your favorite drama or just not wanting to start the day of work, it can really boil you down on the next working day. And this is so rare because you will feel very tired and not being able to finish your work. So another thing that Elon Musk does is that he showers every day. I mean, in Singapore, it's quite common sense because Singapore is a very humid climate. So I guess we do shower every day, definitely. And the last thing that Elon Musk does is that he uses stretch goals. So he sets goals that are unattainable, that are crazily far for him. But to him is that if you are able to set such a huge goal for yourself, at least what you will attain will be more than what you will set, because you would have already worked really hard towards that stretch goal that you made. So once again, we have come to the end of another episode. I hope that this episode has been interesting for you to learn more about the habits or routines of millionaires, and how you can also incorporate them into your lifestyle. If you like what I've been producing, do give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for staying till the end. See you in my next video. Goodbye.